to its head. Good for an old remedy. These will keep. These are helpful. Bitter, though. handy. Solid ice. I'm not getting through here. This must be the pass O'Tor was talking about, with Banuk territory just above. Freezing. The ground, the air, me. sounds a new predator. I can see the heat coming off it.
that.
Thank you.
I'll tuck that away. Welcome, I guess.
You sure you'll be warm enough up here, Nora?
I've worked up a sweat from the climb.
You made it to the cut, Outlander.
Not that you'll stay long.
Smoke rising from the mountain. And the village, too. What's it for?
To meet you at any moment. Trust that our hunters knew this.
How long will Araya stay in retreat, out in the wilds?
Must be something big going on. Most of the village is moving towards that smoke.
Get ready for a rare sight, Nora. Burgrind, purveyor of necessities. Most of the time, the Banuk burn their dead, but not today.
Because the bodies couldn't be recovered.
Aye, a nasty business. All their best warriors, lost. So they're getting a different kind of send-off.
Grasp your grief, my hunters, and kill it! For our kin sees the fate all Banuk long for. falling with their spears striking steel. Their struggle is over now. You have witnessed their spirits rise up into the blue sky and beyond to the blue light. But our struggle is only beginning. Soon, we will again take up the hunt against the daemon that frenzies the machines against us. And so I ask you, can you summon the courage of our fallen kin? Will you fight and die as well as they did?
My courage! My spear!
Our blood is in your teeth, Aratok!
We are Banuk. Our enemies are prey.
The daemon that frenzies the machines.
Machines that wiped out their best.
And what do they want to do?
Go back up there. Fools. A little advice for free.
Aloy.
Aloy. I've been up here for two long winters,
and I still can't make sense of the Banuk.
Take this ruckus. It started with one of their shamans, Aurea, spouting on about spirits and daemons up on Thunder's Drum. So they march their Warwick up there, and half of them get slaughtered by machines.
When Aurea vanished, I thought the crazy might have gone with her, but no.
Here's Big Aratok, gearing them up to do it all over again.
And Aurea is the one who spoke about this daemon?
That's right. Told Aratok and the others that it lives up on Thunder's Drum. And they believed her.
But you don't.
Look, I don't know what Aurea found up there. A shaman's not going to talk to an outlander. The machines in the cut are getting more vicious, that's a fact. It could be because of the daemon, or it could be because they all got indigestion, for all I know. But Aurea's not around to explain. She took off, and no one knows why.
What is it about the Banuk you can't make sense of?
Well, everything's a test to them. A hardship to endure. A challenge to survive.
Seems like they don't have much of a choice in a place like this.
Yeah. A land cold enough to crack teeth, filled with wild animals.
You think they'd accept a little reasonably priced aid?
Well, believe me, I've tried to convince them, but a Banuk with nothing left to prove might just lie down and die.
I want to know more about this daemon.
Mm-mm. It's crazy talk, Aloy.
Or there's something to it. Something connected to how the machines behave.
Then you need to find Aurea. She was last seen headed for the mountains they call the Ice Rests. I've heard only the shamans know the trail beyond those frozen peaks.
But I do know where you could find her apprentice, Naltuk. He went north of the river, chasing rumors.
Rumors?
Not the good kind. Sudden attacks in the snow.
Strange new structures. Some say a new machine. Like no one seen before.
Well, now I'm definitely interested. Thanks for the talk, Bergrund.
Don't mention it.
I wonder if Aratok could tell me more about Aurea or Thunder's Drum. Might be worth a shot.
When Sir is finished, you'll be able to see her.